In the new space age, it could be possible for any reasonable, affluent person to take a trip to space. It's all thanks to companies like SpaceX, Virgin Galactic, and Blue Origin. A major goal of the private space industry is to make space travel accessible, affordable, and safe.
Well, the overarching goal of SpaceX is to try to advance the state of space transport, advance space transport technology to the point where, well, get as far along the path as we can to where space travel is hopefully commonplace at some point in the future, and where we can send large numbers of people and cargo to other planets. And that's the sort of thing that needs to happen for humanity to have a great future in space. So we want to keep pushing that.
It's not just space tourism that will become a reality in the coming decades. NASA and its private space industry partners will also enable the creation of permanent human settlements in space. In the future, humanity will build its own colonies in space, and anyone could become an astronaut and be able to travel to other worlds, such as Mars. 18 astronauts have been selected to begin training for upcoming Artemis missions on and around the moon. NASA's new spacesuit that will be worn on the Artemis missions might look like the suits that astronauts use for spacewalks outside the International Space Station today. However, 21st century moonwalkers will be able to accomplish much more complex tasks than their predecessors, thanks to strides in technological advances that started even before the Apollo program. The term astronaut derives from the Greek word meaning space sailor, which is fitting because space has always been a place of exploration for humans, despite the dangers of space travel.
I think there are many things that we learn as a species as more people are exposed to space missions, what the preparation takes, how we operate together internationally, cooperatively to execute things. I think in a microcosm, you know, we hear this piece as astronauts, this overview effect that you're able to look down on the Earth and you're changed in some way by an appreciation that there aren't country boundaries or the fragility of the Earth. All those things kind of come to the forefront. You know, I think we're all experiencing some of that as well right now with this pandemic situation where that has connected us all in a way internationally that causes us to reconsider our connection and how important it is for us to kind of work together kind of going forward. So
before we could begin to venture into space, we had to overcome many obstacles, including those posed by our own bodies. A human being's biological need for oxygen, food, and water have resulted in years of evolution of specialized spacesuits which protect the human body and keep astronauts alive in extreme environments ranging from vacuum chambers to outer space. Spacesuits are a personalized spaceship that mimics all of the protections from the harsh environment of space and the basic resources that Earth and its atmosphere provide. In order to maintain excellent astronaut health, a number of technological innovations have been developed and improved repeatedly over the decades. The Soviet Union was a dominant power in early spacesuit work as they developed suits for the launch of Yuri Gagarin, the first man in space, in 1961, and the first spacewalk by Alexei Leonov from Volkshod 2 in 1965. The first U.S. spacesuit that was developed specifically for use in spacewalks was the Apollo spacesuit, first used in 1968 on Apollo 7. However, the most well-known spacesuit was the A7LB, which was used for the lunar landings. The spacesuit design hasn't changed much since then. However, last year we witnessed something different when astronauts Bob Behnken and Doug Hurley made their way out to the SpaceX Crew Dragon capsule that launched to the International Space Station on the Demo 2 mission. We noticed that their spacesuits looked different than the ones we are used to seeing. That's because Elon Musk hired Hollywood costume designer Jose Fernandez to design a spacesuit for SpaceX. The design was then handed over to the spacesuit engineers currently working in the field to transform it into an actual functional spacesuit.
We've actually spent a lot of effort on the spacesuit design, on both the functionality and the aesthetics. It's actually really hard because if you just sort of optimize for functionality, it's one thing. If you optimize for aesthetics, it doesn't work. So it's like, okay, how do we make something that looks cool and works? With a key goal here of being that, you know, when people see that spacesuit, they want them to think, yeah, I want to wear that thing one day. So that's the reason for it.
Nevertheless, different suits serve different purposes. SpaceX spacesuits are designed for backup during launches and landings. The suits rely on the life support and communication systems of the spacecraft to protect life in the event of a failure of the capsule's primary life support systems. They are not designed for spacewalks. There is another type that is designed specifically for that purpose. Spacewalking astronauts face radiation, dust, debris, and other extreme temperatures that may vary from as cold as minus 250 degrees Fahrenheit to as hot as 250 degrees in the sunlight. These suits, called EMUs, provide the proper pressure for the body and supply astronauts with water to drink and oxygen to breathe.
I think if you look at the launch and entry suit that we wore during the space shuttle missions, I think in some sense that suit became iconic associated with the mission that was in front of it. I think still when you go and you look in movies, if they're trying to pretend to be astronauts, you'll often see something that's akin to a space shuttle launch and entry suit because people are so familiar with that visual, and it's become in and of itself its own piece of iconography. Now, what we're doing on the SpaceX side and the direction that they've chosen is to kind of reach back and kind of pull forward maybe a retro styling or a different way of creating their own unique kind of mission symbol or symbology, rather than trying to copy what was done on the space shuttle side.
The new suit that will be worn on Artemis missions is called the Exploration Extravehicular Mobility Unit, or XEMU. The 21st century upgrades for the suit that the next moonwalkers will wear will utilize a variety of technological innovations in order to provide a balance between being comfortable, protective, lightweight, and flexible. The use of nanotechnology can aid the development of next-generation spacesuits because it allows for a unique combination of specialized materials to be used that are tailored specifically for the astronauts' needs and are highly functional. The most important upgrades to the spacesuit include safety, mobility enhancements, interchangeable parts, and anthropometry and biomechanics. NASA will continue to push the limits by exploring new frontiers and inviting private sector innovation in the process. They will lead an innovative and sustainable program of exploration with commercial and international partners to send humans farther into space and bring them back home safely.
3, 2, 1, fire.
In order to achieve that, NASA is upgrading all the launch facilities at Kennedy Space Center in Florida that will support Artemis missions to the moon and beyond. Its newest super heavy lift rocket is called the Space Launch System, or SLS. On the launch pad, SLS will stand taller than the Statue of Liberty and will weigh almost 6 million pounds. When it launches, SLS will carry more than any rocket in the world. It will launch to the Orion spacecraft off Earth so that Orion can carry astronauts to the moon. The Orion spacecraft will carry crew to lunar orbit, where they will transfer to a human landing system or the Lunar Gateway. Crews will use the spacecraft to return safely home to Earth, which has been built to withstand the extreme heat experience upon re-entry into the atmosphere. The Gateway is a planned outpost around the moon to support human and scientific exploration into deep space. But with commercial and international partners, the Gateway is critical to sustainable lunar exploration and will serve as a model for future missions to Mars. NASA picked SpaceX to move forward with their Starship HLS design for a crewed demonstration to the surface of Moon.
It's a great honor to be chosen by NASA to return people to the Moon. It's been now almost half a century since humans were last on the Moon. It's too long. We need to get back there and have a big permanently occupied base on the Moon, and then build a city on Mars and become a spacefaring, like a spacefaring civilization, a multi-planet species.
Thanks for watching. Did you like this video? Then show your support by subscribing and ringing the bell to never miss videos like this.